Hejsan och välkomna tillbaka till DDLC, The Fruit of the Leader Club. Förra gången var mer event. Vi fick göra lite grann. Eller mest eller så här, det var snack om event. Så vi gick lite mer av Monica. Och som det ser ut så kommer jag gå på hennes road nu. Som egentligen oh well. Och nu ska jag egentligen planera på dagarna. Gerera. We here.
Alrighty. Do you want to hang out today? Since tomorrow you're helping one of the other girls.
Actually, I have to prepare for something tomorrow. I won't actually be with any of the other girls until Sunday.
Oh, what do you have to prepare for?
Don't worry about it. Sony trots off sticking her tongue out at me. All right, goodbye, Sayori. I turn away and walk home. Oh, train station. Who am I going to meet there? The sky is filled with a marginal amount of clouds. It gives the morning a pleasant depth. I walk up the cement stairs of the station, ready to rendezvous with a contact of mine. Not many people are around here. I guess it makes sense since it's a Saturday. The normal business crowd is never active on the weekends, so the constantly streamlined flows of suits and interns have vanished. I was informed to meet my contact here at 9 a.m. And I try my best to meet my required deadlines. This is for my job after all. As I climb the final step of the unusual long staircase, I look around. Oh boy, vad ska man ta för röster? Philip! Philip over here! Vi köper det. I hear a woman voice call out to me from my southeast. That voice, oh god no. I turn to face the sound of the voice and my fears are confirmed.
Oh, look at you. You're even bigger than when I last saw you, hehe.
What in God's name are you doing here, Julia?
Oh, a new person.
Som vi faktiskt får reda namn på. Before me is an older woman that I have known for quite a while.
Isn't it obvious?
Dear God, don't tell me I'm stuck with you.
Hey, now that is a good way to hurt a girl's feelings.
Girl, you're an entire decade older than me. You may be aware a girl when I first met you, but her face contorts into an annoyed expression.
I see that.
Hur ska vi? Ah, det är så svårt.
I see you haven't changed from your normal pretty self.
I look up and down at her. Up and down at their body. Why would you do that? For being 28, she still looks as if she's passable for someone who isn't even allowed to drink.
Maybe one or two adjustments.
I was just admiring your beauty, Julia.
Gah! No, you aren't. How can you say that? With that mocking grin of your face.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Beauty isn't the right word. She holds up a hand to stop me from continuing. Just forget I even said that. I feel like the next word you were gonna say would be worse than the former. I shrug my shoulders. Let's get this over with already, please. I sit down on a nearby bench. Julia sits down next to me. She's wearing a casual white t-shirt, exposing a little more than her collarbone. Her brunette hair sways slightly in the breeze. Her jean shorts barely cover her upper tights. How do they let you prance around dressed like that?
What? Do you like what you see?
You're on duty, right? Her face stims.
Yes, but it's not like I can meet you in normal attire. We have to remain incognito.
You could have just picked me. You could have just picked me in your car.
It's in the shop right now.
You rear-ended someone again, didn't you? She starts to sweat slightly.
None of your business!
I raise my eyebrows. Was it the car?
Shut up! God, how did you ever become so stubborn?
You serious, right?
You weren't this stubborn, Andrew, when we brought you home.
She crossed her arms. That a fact.
Well, you didn't even open your mouth back then. It was probably better too.
If you say so. Anyway, what exactly did they gave me to do to you?
Well, I heard about the little incident where you told your parish chief off, and that he requested a reassignment for you. And because of your nature,
they saw you as the only person who could control me.
I wouldn't even say control. We haven't been speaking for more than 5 minutes, and you're already insulting me to hell.
And why do you think that is, Julia?
Because you're a dick! Sant? Mycket är en douchebag?
I wrap my arm around her, smirking slightly.
Hey!
Her face starts to redden.
What are you up to?
What is it wrong for me to show you some jag vet inte vad TLC menas, men every once in a while. The image of
getting any top of DLC from you is utterly terrifying in my mind.
She shudders in her seat. I pat her on the shoulder, a pose of me and remove my hand.
Yeesh, why do you do this to me?
It's fun.
You're a sadist.
Well, I expected the word bastard from you, but that works. Kanske inte skulle sagt det där, men acke.
Gjort är gjort. Still no respect for your father, huh?
I hate the man. You know I will never respect him.
I know. It's because of him that...
And that... I raised my hand out in front of her, signaling her to stop.
Right, sorry, Philip.
It's fine.
Anyway, I need your phone.
Here? Reaching into a breast pocket of my white dress shirt, I receive a black folded cell phone. I place it into Julia's outstretched hand.
Thank you.
She smiles as she opens the phone and begins to look through it.
So you're keeping your commission phone for only our contact, right?
Correct.
And you still have a normal civilian phone?
Correct.
Good. Remember to keep the two entirely separate. If we ever need to call you, it won't be from your GP phone.
GP in my field stands for General Purpose for the General Populace. Julia, I'm already aware of this. Why must you give me the same exact lecture from the other chiefs have given me. Because it's procedure. Huh? What are you smirking about over there? You following procedure? Julia, please don't make me laugh. Listen, when I was promoted to division chief, I made sure to hold myself to better standards than myself. So no more nights where you just pop back home at 3 a.m. drunk off your ass. Gah! Listen, okay? I was younger then. Also, you know as well that I... Don't do this. What's that? Also, do you know as well that... As I that... Don't you dare say her name. Huh? Julia looks over at me, puzzled. I step back into her eyes. I said, do not say her name. She looks saddened at my reaction.
You're still not used to her being gone. I can't really blame you. She was like my sister after all.
I'm aware. I chuckled sadly. And she chuckled sadly.
I remember when she and I first found you. Sometimes lit up in her eyes that I never saw before. Even in the heat of the intense operation, she still took a second to re-evaluate everything.
You two didn't have to take me.
Why not? You were going to die there if we didn't.
I don't care. Seeing my growing hostility, Julia discontinues the topic. She hands the black cell phone to me, back to me.
My desk and cell are both in there. Call me only when needed.
Same with you. I'm trying to live a normal life here. I don't need regular calls to the office.
It's really admiring of you to strive for a normal life. I'll try to make sure you do that.
She smiles warmly at me. Her sparkling blue eyes somewhat gives me a glimpse of sincerity. But I know Julia is only saying what I want here. She isn't bound to my wishes, but to whatever she is asked to do about the high-ups. Nevertheless, it was good to see her again. A friendly face is appealing every once in a while. I'm gonna get going now, Julia.
I will call you in a few hours. I want you to be ready.
Right. After a moment of calming silence, I begin to take my leave.
Alright, we... Ow!
I smacked the upper middle of Julia's back.
What the hell was that for?
Heh.
Huh, you...
The black straps of her bra that... Jag vet inte varför jag säger det här. That traversed the inline of her shoulders loosened significantly.
Va? My bra!
I stand up, start to walk away.
God!
No. No, jag tänker inte säga det.
Philip!
You shouldn't have taught me to do that. I wave my right hand in a mock salute as a gesture of farewell.
Ugh!
I start down the stairs, revealing in the sound of Julia's upset huffs and puffs. Så klart, hon blev inte glömt. Det där var inte kul för henne. When I was younger, she had taught me how to very easily undo a girl's bra through her shirt.
Vem lär folk det?
I simply mask my action by slapping her on the back. I chuckle quietly to myself.
23:30, neighborhood.
Snälla, säg inte igen. The sidewalk, which seems to stretch for miles, finally begins to end at my neighborhood. After all of today, training and use, I am beat. I lean against the fence that borders my house, closing my eyes. It honestly sure does feel nice to relax for a moment. After a few minutes, I open my eyes and go inside. I walk into my room after grabbing some food and quickly shoving it down. I reach into one of my desk drawer and grab my normal phone. Lite scary när det är ingen musik alls. I sit down at the foot of my bed. I notice a few text messages in my notification.
Hi Philip, it's Monica. I hope I am not bothering you or anything. I am just wanting to see when you wanted to discuss what we plan on doing tomorrow. Let me know.
I guess I got home right on time since this message was sent about 10 minutes ago. I replied to Monica. Yo, I just got home. What is the plan for tomorrow? I place my phone next to me on the bed and lean back against the wall. I get a response about a minute later.
Well, I was planning on us meeting up somewhere and formulating an itinerary there. Or did you have something else planned?
No, that sounds fine. Where are we meeting up? My place or yours?
It is fine.
Then I will meet you at your place. Monica responds with a message that I am almost positive she had to rewrite a few times, following that with her address. I told her I would arrive around noon. She didn't contest. I look out of my bedroom window and into the neighborhood. It's really quiet and scenery. Like it's one of those atmosphere where you can let your guard down and just relax. Unfortunately, that is never the case for me. Feeling my eyelids grow heavy by the seconds, I retire for the night. 11:50 Central Street. Thank you. Jag vill ha musik. The Sunday traffic is light. It's to be expected. None of the larger corporation of business are operational on Sundays. So the weekday office commuters are off the streets. Mark and I agreed to meet at her house at noon. She gave me her address, which I mapped earlier so I knew to go. Her house isn't that far from mine or the school, which is convenient. It isn't before long that I entered the neighborhood market scene. Here I am. I confirm the house number and knock on the door.
Oh, Philip. I'm so glad you're here.
Right on time.
You're pretty prompt, aren't you?
Huh? Oh, so why are you in your school uniform?
Well, I was thinking we could go to school and kind of lay out the club room.
The school? It is Sunday. It isn't the building closed? Marga reaches into a small pocket on her blazer and pulls out a little metallic key. Ah, so you were entrusted with a master key.
Hehe, you are correct.
How can a student obtain something like that?
I used to be a part of the much larger political school clubs, which helped me get a lot of interesting credits with the school administration. With the festival coming up, I asked the administration in advance if I could access the club room so I can prepare. I originally presumed they were gonna just leave the school gate open and lock the room, but it looks like they just to give me the master key instead.
Interesting.
So I was actually in the middle of something before you showed up. Would you mind if I finish that up when we go?
Sure.
Great, thank you so much.
When I follow Monica inside, I stand near the door and wait for her. Her house has a much different architectural design that I am familiar with. From the front door, there's another door to the left, around 4 feet. Then about 8 there is a second door. At the end of the hallway is another door with a light above the window. Perpendicular to the last door a set of stairs ascends into the house. Make this way up the stairs. After I told her I would wait down here. After a few minutes of silence, Mark calls down from the stairs.
Hey, Philip, I'm sorry I'm taking so long. I'm almost done.
It's fine. Just don't make me wait much longer. We're burning in daylight.
Okay.
Mark had a hint of nervousness in her voice. What is she doing up there? As I was considering going up there, Monica comes back down.
Okay, all done.
It's about time.
Shall we go now?
Hmm? Monica leads the way to the school, me at her side.
Sorry about making you wait again.
It probably isn't in my place to ask, but what were you doing?
Oh, hey, nothing important.
Well, if wasting my time was enough for a reason... Monica visibly shakes.
I was doing girl stuff.
My eyes widen. Okay, we run. I quickly throw words of surrender. Monica nervously shackles. From what I saw, your house is pretty nice.
Thank you. My father bought it for me.
Your father bought you an entire house for yourself?
Well, on paper it says it is for both of us. But he always working, so I never see him.
Her voice trails. As well how nice of him then.
What about your father?
What about that? What about the... Blah? Monica sends my sudden hostility and hesitates.
Not a good relationship with him, huh?
Let's just say I wish the man was dead. Okay, wow, yeah, that is a really bad relationship. Han har ingen vänskap med hans pappa alls, wow.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Monica, don't ever take responsibility for something you didn't do. My father, he was just a very bad man. And I won't forgive him for what he's done, ever.
What about your mom?
I never met her. Monica takes the hint to move on from the subject.
On the lighter note, I have been looking forward to today.
Why is that?
Hey, no reason.
Monica smiles and looks off to the side. I swear you women are so cryptic.
Oh, do you not have that much experience with girls, Philip?
Very little. Monica heads perks up slightly. Bam, 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 bam. Monica and I arrive at the gate of the school. It looks so odd with no one else around. We enter the courtyard and I reach the main doors. So I assume these doors are locked. Got your key?
Actually, there is a facility door we can use in the back.
Monica and I walk around to the back to the school. There are several faded white utility sheds that are used for storing equipment. Next to them is a door labor facility. She inserts the master key and unlocks it.
Yay, it works!
We found ourselves in a darkened room that looks like it is a midnight kitchen. Three white tables on our left for staff to use. Cupboards that I guess hold lunch and snacks and... What's that? Essentials. A sink with a connected dishwasher, a microwave, and several vending machines. This is the teacher's lunch.
It looks like it. I've never been in here before.
Across from us is the door that leads into the school. Ja, jag tror jag slutar för den här videon. Skulle uppskatta om ni likar den här videon. Och om ni är nya i kanalen, subscriba. Så syns vi till nästa video. Tja då!